like speed dating. I'm a liar. You're beautiful. I don't have HPV.
Wouldn't it be weird if I put 20 tabs of acid in that cheeseburger?
Yeah, and then it's like the cheese... My head really is a cheeseburger. And then they find me the next day. I couldn't finish myself.
Oh, Jesus.
All that's left is my mouth.
And a grease spot on the floor.
Hey, what the hell is that, man? You racist against Italians, too? What the
fuck? Are you Italian?
No, I'm Scottish, but I mean, if I'm standing in their place so I can, you know, do some moral grandstanding for a couple of minutes.
Allow me to signal my virtue. Okay, thank you very much. We all think you're great now.
You mentioned that last night. I don't even know what you're talking about. What is virtue signaling?
Explain it's exactly what you just did. Like, you know, if somebody's talking bad about black people and as a white person I feel that I have to stand up or whatever, that's like the most common
shit that I see. Oh, and that's how they start their pre-programmed, preconceived diatribe?
Basically.
Yeah.
And they're like, hey, you can't say all lives matter. And I'm like, you're right, no lives matter.
You know, I can understand why people would be like, look, saying all lives matter when we're trying to call attention to a specific problem is kind of like being an attention whore. I understand that, but also at the same time, I think you're going way fucking overboard whenever you say people who say things like all lives matter, that's somehow like a racist statement. It's not. It's just kind of selfish. That's all.
Well, I mean, if the situation was anywhere near as bad as they or the mainstream media would like you to believe, then yeah, I'd be saying Black Lives Matter too, but no.
But white they do are matter, Dayton. They do.
But white people are killed per capita in greater numbers than
black
people.
Well, motherfucker, we all gonna die.
Precisely. That's why I say no lives matter. Because guess what? Your family's gonna be sad, and that's about it. And guess what? In fucking 20 years, they'll forget all about you, too. They'll be like, that was sad. Remember that guy that used to live here and pay for all our shit? Well, he's fucking dead now.
Who, Dad?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, man. You really you're the Norman Rockwell of Let's Players, man.
Hold all these edgy opinions?
I was so mesmerized by your velvety voice that I completely and totally forgot what I was going to say.
Awesome, I win.
Anyway, about the All Lives Matter thing, a second ago, I said it's selfish. The idea even isn't selfish. Obviously, it's like the opposite of that. It's like this ubiquitous, altruistic, rule that everybody should live by.
Yeah.
But its application as a response to the hashtag and movement of Black Lives Matter is kind of selfish. Because, like I said, they're trying to bring attention to a very specific thing.
Specific thing, which, according to crime statistics, doesn't really pan out. You know what I mean? If you look at the Department of Justice statistics.
Okay, here's the thing, though, man. Wouldn't you say, at the very least, if one innocent person gets shot by a cop, that's one time too many? Wouldn't you agree with that statement, at least?
Yes.
That's a problem? Mm-hmm. All right. Well, if you go on the YouTubes and do some video searchings, you can see multiple examples of stuff like that. So, I mean, you don't have to say, oh, it's an epidemic or whatever. I don't even really care about statistics. To me, everything's 50-50. Something either happens or it doesn't. And I would like to make sure that I don't get shot by a cop, please. Or my beloved dog Otis, and you know, so well, that's something that I would.
You've technically got a higher
about.
Chance than the black person, according to the statistics.
Oh, thanks! That really makes me feel better. All lives matter except for Jeremy.
No, I said no lives matter. I don't give a shit. Like,
oh, that's fucking edgy, dude.
This is, isn't it?
This is the edgy show.
Watch out! Watch out, he's coming with some opinions you might not agree with. Whoa-ho!
Dayton does irreverence.
That's been kind of the thing. I went full shitlord a while ago, and I ain't coming back.
Really? Because I remember so many years ago when we first met at the gym. You were talking to me about like, oh man, I'm just trying to have fun and play the game, and I don't really want to like. If people want my political opinions about stuff, they can just look it up, because you know I'm just trying to play some games. And I'm like, all right, man, but you should probably just, you know, be the Bill O'Reilly that you want to be. And your life might... Whoa. What's up with your warrior here, dude? Are you seeing this?
He can't swim. Yeah.
Oh, man. Yeah. Let's laugh my God! At him.
Fucking hot dogs coming out of the volcano.
That's great.
I mean, honestly, generally, if I'm like, let's playing something, I won't go out of my way to be like, let's make this completely political. Unless I'm doing a collab. I do like... shove my opinion down the throats of others, but like,
okay,
that's why I hold the edgy opinions that I do, right?
What's an opinion?
Opinions. It's
was
like
that,
was
that the really hot chick from Boy Meets World?
Opinion. God damn. I just wanted to stick it in opinion.
Who didn't?
That's
you know.
True. I mean,
well,
not
I got
anymore.
Missiles out of nowhere. How did that happen?
Missiles?
Yeah, like I fired a couple of tactical warheads. That was weird.
We're doing pretty good.
Yeah, pretty good for me not even paying attention to what's even going on the screen.
Yeah, that's why I like the Necromancer. I'll just stand here and be like, oh, things are dying. That's great.
See, look, I just fired some warheads. Did you see that shit?
I heard the sound, but I wasn't looking at you.
God damn.
Alright, you gonna
this
do it
is what
again?
Happens, you vote for George W. Get him back in office.
Oh shit. See, there's the edgy opinion. No, it's not really edgy.
I was just playing. That's Nobby Joe talking, that's not me.
Oh,
I don't
yeah,
support
that's what I
any president ever. See, look
oh
at that.
Oh my God!
Whizzed right by your head. They're
that
heat
shit was
seeking,
awesome.
Too. That's great! All I'm doing is attacking, too. It's just doing it automatically.
Oh, that's even better than fucking stupid crap, whatever the hell it was.
Yeah.
Yeah, stupid crap.
Go to hell, stupid crap.
I think
I
it was
only
Molotov.
Like intelligent crap.
Molotov cocktail. I get it. I remember the words that I wanna to wanna use now. I wanna to wanna use.
I want you to want me.
I mean, as a friend, I do, for sure.
All right. I need you to need me.
I mean, who really needs anybody? That's...
Dayton, I'd love for you to love me.
All right. I can love you. I can love you so good. I'm just going to spit in your mouth a little bit.
Hey,
call
man.
You a whore.
That's
how you know I love you. Okay?
You know, I'm starting to get to the heart of your controversial opinions.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Are you going to...
I'm dragging it back to the source.
what is it? I'd like to know about me.
Well, you know, I'm just... We'll save a final analysis for, you know, for
that's,
later.
That's so
for when the for when your check clears.
Oh my God!
I leveled up! Die. I am a man now.
Dude, my skeletons are so buff.
They're becoming a, what's the man equivalent of it? I guess it'd just be a, never mind, I'm an idiot. I'm not
man,
even gonna finish the thought.
A man skeleton?
I'm just full of stupidity.
Full of knowledge!
Is that what you call it, eh?
I mean, for some people, stupidity's knowledge.
Totally.
Something.
I mean, because
yeah,
you can't, like,
holy shit.
You can't call a thought, like, a thing, man. It's like it exists in a different, like, reality space as, like, from your body, you know?
Yeah, dude, once you think it, it's already out in the universe, man. Like,
it's
all
like,
kinds of
it's
universes.
It's like it was there before, and your brain is just, like,
It's a transceiver.
Yeah. I believe all of this shit.
Sounds good to me. Fuck it. Yeah. I don't know what I believe, honestly. Like, I'll take the edgiest opinion, and I'm like, okay, that's cool.
Do you believe in free will, Brandon Dayton? Are you the master of your own fate?
No.
Oh, okay. That's settled.
I had a dream.
Martin Luther King!
That I
You're
went
not
to jail.
All bad.
And then I went to jail, and I was like, I knew that feeling, you know? I was like, holy
been
shit.
Been there, done that?
Yep, I've been here before. I dreamt about this.
Wow.
And I could remember it so vividly.
Never happened to me. It never happened.
It doesn't happen to me often, but yeah, that is one instance that I can remember really, really vividly.
For obvious reasons. I did have a dream, though, of my grandmother trying to kill me with, like, a kitchen knife, and she was nude.
Oh.
And that felt real, but it also could have felt that way because I just watched, like, Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas, and there's a point, you know, in the movie where Johnny Depp sort of talks about that.
Yeah.
I forget exactly what the quote is, but it's, like, some kind of trip. I think it was from, like, that hormone that they took out of the human brain, whatever it was.
DMT.
Adrenochrome.
Oh,
I forget. Yeah. DMT, what do I look like to you? A fake yuppie hippie guy?
That shit's legit. That shit's so awesome.
Yeah, but I'm not going to go on any kind of office retreat so I can get to know, you know, HR better, you know?
You don't want to drink ayahuasca with your boss?
No! I mean, only if there are machetes present.
Yeah, then you could have, like, a fight to the death. That would be the best.
I would send him to hell. We would battle in the spirit world.
Yeah, you'd see him, and you'd just be like, I'm so
this
sorry.
This is my true face.
Jesus. Oh, Jesus.
What, you don't think about that sort of thing?
I don't know. I've got dark thoughts. I got
really?
Some dark thoughts.
Like Marilyn Manson, kind of dark?
Darker.
Like Samuel L. Jackson kind of dark?
Like Sam Pepper kind of dark.
Delicious pepper.
I can't remember who Sam Pepper is, and I hope I didn't just, like, say something horrible.
Yeah, I have no idea what you said. I just enjoy pepper.
Yeah, pepper's good. That's for sure.
I can get behind that.
Sometimes they try to skimp me on it, you know? They're like, oh, we just need to put a little bit of salt on here. Ain't no pepper. Well, they are together. It's like ebony and ivory on your very own Thanksgiving table. Or whatever the fuck.
Well, that's, you know, like, there are different colors of pepper, Brandon. I don't know
is
if
that
you
true?
Know this. Yeah, you can actually repackage this video if you like to be, you know, a culinary, what do you call it? And ask an expert. I happen to be a pepper expert.
A pepspert?
A pepspert, yes. And you're just gonna get so many views on this video because people are gonna be looking it up because they want to learn about all the myriad of colors and varieties that pepper comes in.
They're not gonna get any of those answers.
No?
Are you gonna tell them about the pepper?
Yeah, there's like it's all the colors of the rainbow. You know?
Please tell the people about the pepper.
The full spectrum of peppers.
Mmm.
It really just runs the gamut. You can't go wrong.
I want blue pepper.
You know what? I think I have no idea if that exists. I'm not a pepspert. I lied. I'm sorry.
I feel really betrayed.
I just,
you know?
I just want attention, and I want to make friends, and I'm sorry.
Yeah, I do that too. I'm just like, hey, let me lie to you about it, to your face about this thing.
Well, at least you ask first. Man, I never even thought of that. That would solve a lot of my problems.
Just start in.
All the treachery and betrayal, get that out of the way, you know?
Keep it simple.
Like speed dating. I'm a liar. You're beautiful. I don't have HPV.
Speed dating is so fun.
I've never done it.
Well, yeah.
I just got out of a 9-year marriage, so I think I kind of...
Go speed dating.
I thought that was like a thing that's over now. I thought everybody just does the Tinder these days.
Ew.
Oh, they don't? I don't give a fuck, man. I'm not looking for a serious relationship. I'll get all kinds of diseases. Fuck it.
Ew. Yeah, I'm the judgmental kind. She's like, wanna have a one-night stand? And I'm like, whore. Nope.
Wow, you're
never
the kind
call
of,
her again.
You're the problem. You're a problem for me, dude.
Why?
Because I don't... I'm lazy. I don't want to have to, like, work to get laid. I just want to be like, hey, I like you. You like me. Let's, you know, go behind the dumpster here and, you know, then maybe there's, off to Red Lobster.
There's plenty of degenerates that will. But
I do,
as
but
for me, personally, I go, ugh, stay away.
You're just making it. You're making it hard for me, though. If more girls had the sexual attitude of men, then you know I wouldn't have to work hard at all. And neither would you. Don't you see? Don't you see? It's right there in front of your face. Smell
of course.
It. What does
I could
it smell
be like,
like?
I could be like, yay, whores. But like, yeah. To be honest. Like, why do you want a blown-out vagina? You know what I mean?
I don't know. Why would anybody want my chewed-up dick? I mean,
I don't
really?
Know.
Look at it. It's nothing.
I don't want to look at it. Please put it away.
I have nothing between my legs.
I mean, I guess it's because my charisma score is high. You know what I mean?
Oh,
so, like,
yeah.
Rather than
that.
Subjecting myself to a bunch of women, which I easily could... I'd rather say no and know that you wanted to and kind
of... Well, just for once, why don't you think of the less fortunate? I think of you every time I have sex. The least you could do is think of me enough to...
Do you want, like, some of their numbers or something, or...?
Yeah, well, yeah, actually. I mean, I didn't want to come out and say it. I didn't want to be rude, but...
Just hook it up, dude.
Yeah, if you had something in mind, you know.
My brother.
I said something. Yeah, I'll take farm animals too. Whatever. As long as it's a girl, cause hey, I don't swing that away.
That's right. You gotta have some standards.
Yeah. I will fuck a goose, but it must be a feminine goose.
Well, yeah, that's goose gander, right?
Wait, no, that's a gander is the male of the.
Yeah. So a goose would be the female. You don't have to specify. You just say goose. And then if someone brings you a gander, you go, what the fuck, are you retarded?
Yeah.
Are you?
I can't fuck this. I don't know what kind of crazy backwards place you come from where people...
Actually, all birds only have one hole, and it's called a cloaca.
That's right, I know, and their poop comes from there, and their eggs. You're right. God.
Yeah.
You're so much smarter than me.
Learning and fun. I'm not smart. I just know stupid random facts because I read a lot of Uncle John's Bathroom Reader. You remember that book? You ever see that shit?
No, but I imagine it smells fantastic.
It was great. They're like, let me tell you weird stories while you're taking a shit. And I'm like, that's all I ever wanted. My dad ain't gonna do it.
See, you're bringing up the dad again. It's just, I'm making mental notes. And you know, I think we're gonna hit a breakthrough, and we're gonna
I can't wait, dude. I want to break
progress.
Down crying and just be like, oh my god,
it's true. I want to be a mermaid. Call back. You remember you because you were talking about mermaids.
Oh, right? You didn't get your treat. That's all right.
I had a treat.
Yeah, on the little pedestal. Oh. Oh shit, did we win?
Is that the whole game? Oh no.
I guess not.
That was a weird cutscene.
Yeah. Mm. It was awesome though. You had like a chainsaw and shit. Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4. Goodbye, goodbye, see you again. Goodbye, goodbye, see you again.